The feud between actress Rosie O'Donnell and radio talk show host Ben Shapiro has taken an explosive turn, with the conservative commentator saying he's testing Twitter to see if its policies on harassment are fair and balanced. And he's using O'Donnell tweets that included a vulgar sexual term to try to find out. Just reported at Rosie for targeted harassment, mainly to see if Twitter does indeed have a double standard. Everyone knows if Rosie were conservative, Twitter would suspend her in a hot second. So, Twitter, put your money where your mouth is, Shapiro tweeted, adding the popular MeToo hashtag. He elaborated, it's an attempt to clarify Twitter's standards. I don't actually want them to ban or suspend Rosie. I want them to stop applying their own rules inconsistently. It's an attempt to clarify Twitter's standards. I don't actually want them to ban or suspend Rosie. Ben Shapiro later, Shapiro tweeted again, surprise of surprises. Twitter says that Rosie's tweets were not in fact abusive in any way under the rules. Good to know. Earlier this week, O'Donnell said she would give $2 million each to Senators Susan Collins and Jeff Flake if they voted against the tax reform legislation. Shapiro, who is also the editor-in-chief of The Daily Wire, responded with a series of jabs at the liberal former co-host of The View. One tweet cited an article he wrote for his website claiming, Rosie O'Donnell violates federal law, offers to bribe Republican senators to vote against tax bill. Another tweet called for O'Donnell to be locked up, while Shapiro also joked, if Trump orders Sessions to investigate Rosie, he will be carved into Rushmore by Friday. After the barrage of Shapiro posts, O'Donnell sent a profanity-laced reply, "Suck my D, Ben." The exchange continued, leading Shapiro to make even more claims against O'Donnell. You're already a felon, Rosie. Don't be a homophobic sexual harasser too, replied Shapiro. After Shapiro alerted his followers that he had reported O'Donnell, she simply replied, "Oh, Ben," to which he answered, "All victims deserve to be believed." O'Donnell's account was still active at the time this story was published, although she did block Shapiro.